Welcome to the next practical session of embedded software testing. We studied in the earlier session about how to create test cases from an embedded software requirement, and we also learned about the checklists that are required to do the embedded software verification and validation. And today we'll try to understand the traceability between requirements to test case. Okay, so for traceability, you know that it should trace from the requirements to test case one level, and from test case to requirements, both the levels are important so that we have the coverage. Okay, let's try to open the SRS document, and we'll also try to open test specification. Okay, now we have, what we have to do is using an Excel sheet we should create a traceability such that we are covering every aspects. Okay, okay. So now what are the inputs that we need for traceability? As we said, we need test cases, we need requirements, similarly other one. So we will create upward traceability and downward traceability. Okay, in upward traceability we need test cases to requirement. So number test case requirements, let's do this way. Let's try to create few samples and try to identify those things what we have covered. Okay, so now we'll go by the test case. So how many test cases we have, we go through the test requirements, we'll come to know. Okay, so we have SRS2, TC1, TC2, TC like this, we have about 10. So we'll copy this, we'll paste it here. Next we have this one, next set of test case here, next one is here, why we are done, 6, similarly we have test cases for the next set of things. So likewise we are going to make it. Next one is the requirements. Okay, so this test cases what we have identified here all for requirement, this right, so we need to put that. So we have about test case 1 to 10 for the first the SRS2. So these are all SRS2 type of requirements. So we have the next set of requirements, SRS3. Okay. Okay, next we have SRS4. Okay. So by seeing this, you know that it is from okay, this is basically upward traceability. Other one we should try is downward. Okay, so in upward traceability we try to cover how many test cases are there. So what will happen is at the end of this, so So we can put some formula in Excel sheet to see that missing requirements. So there are few requirements which are missed, like SRS 1 we are not covered. Okay, so what will happen is we will be able to identify what are the requirements that we have missed with this upward traceability, right? So those requirements we need to address by adding a new test cases. That's what this traceability will help basically. So first one is this actually. So what will happen is this requirement, we know that this will go in different modes actually. So we need to put the embedded instrument in operational, so that we know operational type of requirements will cover both init as power up. So wherever we have a test case for operational mode type of requirements, say when modes go to operational mode, this is the one, suppose this will cover SRS 1 also along with SRS 3, right? So this is SRS 1 it is covering. So likewise, we are going to have a coverage of missing requirements. If still it is missed, we are not able to trace some of the requirements, then we need to do some sort of analysis in what way I can cover it up, whether I can do it with the existing test cases or should I do it separately. So that way it's very important to have a traceability, to have a coverage of all the requirements from the test case perspective. Okay, the next one is downward traceability. Here what will happen is we start with requirements, we go with test cases. So what will happen is so all the requirements first it will be listed basically. Suppose we have 10 requirements. Please remember that these SRS IDs are incremental, but sometime what will happen is over a period this could have been deleted, it may not be there. So assume that all the SRS have been brought up here, and for each of the SRS we have a test case, like in terms of test case ID. See, in the first one we have test case one, and this is also SRS 2, right? So we have test case 2. So SRS is same, SRS is same, SRS is same, SRS is same. Like this we have 10 test cases for the same requirement. Okay, so we know that from requirement how many test cases have been drawn. Okay, now SRS 3, SRS 4, likewise we are going to list out test cases. So what will happen is there will be some test cases which would have missed for a particular SRS, so that we are going to tell that as missing test cases. That means test cases we have not covered for certain requirements. This way downward traceability will be achieved. So with the help of this we are going to have upward and downward traceability. We are going to create a complete report of how many requirements have been addressed, how many requirements are there in terms of missing. All this will be part of the traceability. That is what we do with traceability. Basically we will try to establish a traceability and identify the matrix for the developed test scenarios for the set of requirements. Okay, that is about traceability. We studied about SRS and creating the test cases and review checklist. We have seen the next exercise that day, we have seen about the LDRA code coverage and structural coverage, LDRA unit test generation and management with LDRA unit at example demo event. Then we also studied about target debugging using CodeWarrior. There was a video we also went through, and we will try to study a test link, how it can be used, and There is another tool called Bugzilla, similar to TestLink. This also can be used. So what we do is there is an online TestLink session. We will try to see that. And login. Basically, we need to create the demo project that the TestLink people have created through online. You can do so, but ideally, in a project, what will happen is there is a local server like Apache or something. So, with the help of that, they will create all the connections with that local server and create the individual access with the user ID and all that. So here is the page you can see. We need to log in to the TestLink. You know that the TestLink we can use to manage the test cases and requirements, execution, results, and the traceability. Complete report will be done. Only thing is, first time we need to enter manually. Or we can import from requirements documents such as Word or Doors. So that option is also there. Once we are done with adding all those information, what is required for test management, we can generate the test report. And similarly, the Bugzilla also can be used. Those are the steps that we require for TestLink. Okay, here you can see the basic window of a TestLink. It's a sample. It's available online. For an understanding of how it is used, we can use this. So for a test project, we have users like admin, tester, and test manager, etc., quality people. It's up to us how we want to define the different roles of the project. So we can assign the user roles, the existing ones, or we can add users if you are an admin in terms of the test stakeholders. Basically, you can see an example here. There are a number of users here. It's up to you how you want to add them. So the different roles have been created. This also you can create. Who can do what? This is an example that they have created. So there is admin, tester, leader, and all that. So based on the need of the project, you can use it. You can filter. The roles who are all assigned, that also you can do with this test designer, let us say. So these are the people who are having a test designer role. Okay, so that they have access to have a test cases designed and added into this portal. Okay, so that is about test project roles. The next one is test plan roles. Similarly, test plan also we can have it. The example project that has been created. And you can set the roles for doing the test plan. So we have a test plan as well as test design. Test design is nothing but the test cases or the test specification creation. So here also we can find who is admin for this project. Just an example. Usually one admin will be there who will maintain adding the users, deleting, and maintaining the reports and all that. Like what we have seen in one of our theoretical sessions of software configuration management, like CC role and all that. Similar to that, it is okay. So similarly, we can have